So while the obvious one-fingered chord is the most well-known, there are other chords that you can play in Spanish, of course. The next one I'm going to show you is an open C, and that goes like this. So you got your ring finger on the first string, second fret, index finger on the second string, first fret, open third string, and then your middle finger, second fret, fourth string, and because it's C and this is a G, which is part of the C chord, you can play that as well if you want. C major. To make that C major 7, we actually have to go quite far out of that shape up to here. So you want to play the 5th fret of the 5th and 4th strings, open 3rd, open 2nd, and then the 2nd fret of the 1st string, which makes a really nice C major 7. Now to get a C dominant 7, you go back to that normal C chord there, and take this little finger, put it on the 3rd fret of the 3rd string, C dominant 7. C major 6, you want open 5th string, 2nd fret of the 4th and the 3rd string, 1st fret of the 2nd string, and then the 2nd fret of the 1st string. That's C major 6. C augmented, you want to bar those bottom 4 strings on the 1st fret, and then on the 1st and the 4th, you make it the 2nd fret. Then to do C suspended 4, you want to play the 3rd fret of the 1st and 4th, leave the 3rd string open, and the 1st fret of the 2nd string. C suspended 4. And then if you want to go back to playing just a regular C major, you just want to shift those two back down 1 fret. And again, you can just play it on 1 string. Doesn't matter which one it is, whether it's the 1st or the 4th. So the next chord we're doing here is the C minor, and that is just the 1st fret on the 1st, 2nd and 4th strings. You leave the 3rd string open. C minor. And to turn that into C suspended 2nd, you take the 1st and 4th strings off and leave that one finger on there on the 2nd string, 1st fret. C suspended 2nd. Now to get a C minor 7, you want to play a bar across the bottom 4 strings on the 1st fret, and you want to play an open 5th string, but you want to add a finger to the 3rd fret of the 3rd string. C minor 7. C minor major 7 is a bit of an odd shape, so you want to bar the first 2 strings at the 1st fret, and then you want to play the 3rd string, 4th fret. And then if you can reach, you want to play the 5th string at the 5th fret, but use that little finger to muffle the 4th string so it's not being played. A little awkward, but it sounds nice. Next up, C minor 7 flatted 5th, which is a little easier to play. Bar those first 2 strings at the 1st fret again, then the 3rd string at the 3rd fret, and the 4th string at the 4th fret. Now we move to C minor 6, and that's open 5th string, 1st fret, 4th string, and bar that all the way down to the 1st string, and then on the 3rd string, you want the 2nd fret. C minor 6. So like the G major chord before, you can bar it by just basically shifting the chord up the neck. This is a little more involved than that one fingered chord though, so here's the C major. And if we shift that up 1 fret and take care of what used to be open strings, you can see the pattern there is, and then you use that finger to cover that. You can play the 5th string if you want as well. So in this instance we're going to be playing F major, which is, yes, that's this one. Now this shape isn't too good for a few of these chords, so kind of winging it with this F dominant 7, which shouldn't be a triad, but I'm just going to go with it because it's very hard to reach otherwise. So you want to play the 5th fret of the 3rd string, 4th fret of the 2nd string, and 7th fret of the 1st string. Again with the F major 6, not easy to reach, so I've just reduced it to a 3 note chord. 3rd string 5th fret, 2nd string on the 6th fret, and 1st string on the 9th fret, I believe, yes. And that's your F6. Now to get the F augmented, you just want to drop that one finger there down a fret. So it's 5, 6, 8. Moving back to 4 string chords now. You want to go from the 7th fret on the 4th string, 6th fret of the 3rd and 2nd strings, and then the 7th fret of the 1st string again. And that is F suspended 4. To get a minor chord out of this shape, it's nice and easy. You play 4th string on the 6th fret, 3rd string on the 5th, and then the 2 below, you play again on the 6th. So to turn that into F suspended 2nd, you just want 5th fret bar and then 6th fret on the 2nd string, and play those bottom 4 strings again. And that's F suspended 2nd. F diminished is 6th fret on the 4th string, 4th fret on the 3rd string, and then 6th fret again on the bottom 2 1st and 2nd strings. F diminished. F minor major 7 is 6th fret this time on the 4th string, 5th fret on the 3rd string, 6th fret on the 2nd string. So you'll need to do it like this because the 1st string is way down at the 2nd fret. Hard to reach, but sounds nice if you can do it. Moving on from that, we have F minor 7 flatted 5th, 1st fret of the 5th string, 3rd fret of the 4th string, which you'll need to do this way, and then 4th frets of the 3rd and 2nd strings. F minor 6 is maybe the easiest minor 6 on here. You bar the bottom 4 strings at the 5th fret, and then you play the 6th fret on the 1st and 2nd string. F minor 6. So there is one more chord shape that I'm going to show you, and it's very similar to the C, in fact. So here's the C major chord. Now if we take the index finger off and put it on the 3rd string 1st fret instead of the 2nd string 1st fret, and drop that 5th string, so we only play the bottom 4 strings now. 2nd fret 4th, 1st fret 3rd, open 2nd string, and 2nd fret for the 1st string. And that gives you the E major chord. And again, if we follow what we did before, we go down to E major 7, and we get that by dropping this or this one down. So 1st fret 1st string, open 2nd string, 1st fret 3rd string, and then 2nd fret on the 4th string. E major 7. Now for E dominant 7, that's nice and easy. You play that usual E chord there, and then you take this finger off. So open 1st string. Next one down is E augmented, and you want to bar 1st fret on the 4th, 3rd, 2nd, 1st strings, and then using your middle and your ring finger, play the 2nd fret. Now you might recognise that from earlier as the C augmented chord. It is also E augmented, they share the same notes, so that's nice of them. E suspended 4th, you want to play 2nd fret on the 1st, 3rd and 4th strings, leaving the 2nd string open. E suspended 4. Now to get E5, it's a little bit of a tricky position, but it can be done. So that's 2nd fret of the 4th string, 4th fret of the 3rd string, open 2nd string, and 2nd fret of the 1st string. And again, the E5 chord is basically a power chord, so you may want to just do it that way if it's easier for you. Moving on from that, we have the E minor chord. Now this is one that was used in the Three Lions lesson, and it's very straightforward. You're going to play all of the D strings, so that's 1st, 4th and 6th, at the 2nd fret, and leave the rest open. E minor. Now if we want to make that an E suspended second, you put the 4th string and the 3rd string at the 4th fret, open 2nd string, and then 1st string at the 2nd fret. That gives you E suspended 2nd. Now if we go back to the E minor chord, which is on all those 2nd frets on the 6th, 4th and 1st strings, and we just take one of those off, doesn't matter which, you get E minor 7. Now if we do that with the other finger off, sounds like that. So they are a little different, kind of inversions of each other. E minor 7. To get E diminished, we want to play the 2nd fret of the 4th string, 3rd fret of the 3rd string, and for this one, you probably want to use these two fingers there, and then bar the 1st and 2nd strings at the 5th fret. That is about as awkward as they come, but it makes a good chord, so. E diminished. E minor major 7. Now that is that E minor chord again. But instead of taking it all the way off to open on the 1st string, you want to take it to the 1st fret. So E minor with a major 7. Very mysterious. E minor 7 flatted 5th. Now that's an open 5th string. 2nd fret on the 4th string, 3rd fret on the 3rd string, 3rd fret on the 2nd string, and open 1st string. Equally mysterious. E minor 6 is open 5th string, 5th fret of the 4th string, 4th fret of the 3rd, and then 2nd fret of the 1st and 2nd, so you want to bar that there with your index. So that's E minor 6. Now if we take that E chord, the open E, and move that up one fret, we can do the same as we did before to make a bar chord. So fill in where the open string would have been. And you can see it's very similar to the last one, but this time we're going back down that way, and the last string is that 1st string which mirrors the 4th again. Interesting to note here, if you play it like this, it's the same shape as your standard major chord, with the root on the 6th string on standard tuning, but here that plays a dominant 7th. So dominant 7th in that shape, but we're going to do it with the A chord here, so we go up to the 7th fret to do it. So major, A major, 7th fret, 6th fret, 5th fret, 7th fret. And then you play that standard tuning major chord, and that gives you a dominant 7. To get A6, we have this sort of F major 7 kind of thing in standard, where you go 7, 6, 5, 4. Lovely. And then to play A augmented, you want the 7th fret again, and you want that on the 1st and the 4th string, and the 6th fret for the 3rd and 2nd. A major 7, you want to play the 7th fret 4th string, 6th fret of the 3rd, 5th fret of the 2nd, and you're going to want the 6th fret of the 1st string, so you probably use your little finger on that 7th fret there for the 4th string. Next one is A suspended 4th, and that's relatively easy from this position. You want 7th fret on the 4th and the 3rd, 5th fret on the 2nd string, and 7th fret on the 1st string. And that's your A suspended 4th. A minor is equally easy, and probably my favourite minor shape for this tuning, because it's just 7th fret, 5th fret, 5th fret, 7th fret. Beautiful minor chord. So if you want to drop that, we've gone major, minor, if you want to drop it to a suspended 2nd, you would play, if you can reach, the 4th fret on the 3rd string, the 5th fret on the 2nd string, and the 7th fret on the 1st, and if you can reach, the 7th fret on the 4th as well. You do get a bit of muffling there, so you may want to stick with the 3. Okay. Okay, so A minor 7, this is probably the easiest minor 7th shape for Spanish, and that's the 7th fret again of the 4th string, 5th fret of the 3rd, 2nd and 1st strings, and again, because of the way the strings go, you can play it that way, or you can put your little finger down on the 1st string 7th fret, or you can bar right up to the 5th string and keep either one of those down, and you've still got the nice minor 7th there. Next is A diminished, and doesn't really have anything to do with this position. I just wanted to chuck it in there so there was another way to play diminished. And this one, you want to bar all 6 strings at the 1st fret, and then the 2nd fret for the 5th string and the 3rd string. A diminished, lovely. So next one is A minor major 7, and that starts on the 7th fret of the 4th string again, down to the 5th fret of the 3rd and 2nd strings, and then the 6th fret of the 1st string. So that's a pretty clean minor major 7th, they're usually a bit tricky to play, so that may be one for you to remember if you like that kind of sound. Minor 7, flatted 5th, you're going to play the 5th fret of the 4th and 3rd strings, the 4th fret of the 2nd string, and then the 7th fret of the 1st string. Again, this is a little tricky. So it might be easier to just play it that way on the 4th, 3rd and 2nd string. So 7th, 5th and 4th. A minor 6, which is the 3rd fret of the 4th string, 4th frets of the 3rd and 2nd strings, and then somehow, so you might want to bar that with your middle finger and then just play that 6th fret of the 1st string. A minor 6. So that is just a quick look at some of the different shapes and variations of the chords available to you in Spanish tuning. I hope if you haven't tried an open tuning before, then this video might motivate you to do so. It's very versatile, it's not just restricted to playing the blues, and as you can see, even that basic one finger chord has a multitude of variations, so it's not just a quick cheat, but again, there's obviously nothing wrong with using it that way if that's what you want to do, if that's what you're comfortable with. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please do leave a like if you did, subscribe, hit the bell, and you can find us on Facebook as well, Regulus Recording Co. I do live stream there from time to time, so go follow me over there if you want to see even more content that is not here already on the YouTube channel. Next time we're going to be having a look at how to play a couple of different scales in Spanish tuning, so take it steady and I'll see you then.